Hello children, let us continue with textile exercise lesson 1. We have already completed question 3 and now we are going to do question 7. As the question says, an object moves 18 meters in the first 3 seconds, 22 meters in the next 3 seconds and 14 meters in the last 3 seconds. What is the average speed? Right? To calculate average speed, we require two things: total distance and total time. So according to this question, total distance covered, which are the distances here? 18 meters plus 22 meters and plus 14 meters. So 18 plus 22 plus 14, that gives us 54 meters. Correct? Now let us see the time. We have in the first distance in 3 seconds. We have the second distance also in 3 seconds. And the third distance also in 3 seconds. So total 3 plus 3 plus 3, that is equal to 9 seconds. Now let us come back to the formula. Average speed is equal to total distance upon total time. 54 meters upon 9 seconds. So that gives us 6 meters per second. So that gives us 6 meters per second. A very easy sum, right? Now, similarly, let us also do D. Let us also do D. Question 7D. A person swims 100 meters in the first 40 seconds, 80 meters in the next 40 seconds and 45 meters in the last 20 seconds. What is the average speed? Same way we have to do. Total distance covered 100 meters plus 80 meters plus 45 meters. So the total comes to 225 meters. Now total time taken. The first distance in 40 seconds, second distance in again 40 seconds and the third distance in 20 seconds. Correct? So that comes to 40 plus 40 plus 20, which is 100. So average speed is total distance upon total time, which comes to 225 meters upon 100 seconds. So the answer is 2.25 meters per second. Now just one reminder children, in the textbook they have given 2.25 meters per second square. But just now you have seen it is not 2.25 meters per second square. Rather you are getting the answer as 2.25 meters per second. They have asked you to find speed. So the unit of speed is meters per second. And what is printed in the textbook is 2.25 meters per second square. It is not second square, it is only seconds. Okay. So just make the correction. Now, coming to question 7b, an object of mass 16 kg is moving with an acceleration of 3 meters per second square. Okay. Calculate the applied force. Calculate the applied force. Now we have taken capital F as the force. So you know the force equation. F is equal to M into A. But here we have taken the mass of the first object as M1 and the acceleration as A1. In the first part of the question, they have asked us to calculate force. Now, according to the information given, M1 is 16 and A1, which is given in the question, is 3. So, force is equal to 48 newtons. Force is equal to 48 newtons. So, we are having an object of mass 16 kg, which is moving with an acceleration of 3 meters per second square. And they asked us to calculate applied force and we have calculated the force as 48 newtons. If the same force is applied on an object, if the same force means for the second part of the question also, we will take force as 48 newtons. For the second part of the question also, we will take force as 48 newtons. If the same force is applied on an object of mass 24 kg. The first object was having mass 16 kg. Second object is having the mass as 24 kg, which means the two objects are different. Correct? So our first object 16 kg, mass is M1. Our second object we have taken mass as M2, which is 24 kgs. Which is 24 kgs. Okay? And what they are asking us to find, how much is the acceleration? How much is the acceleration? Children, again the force equation, this time it is mass 2 and this time it is acceleration 2, that is for the second object. Same force, so we are taking 48. Mass of the second object is 24, and this is A2. So 48 by 24 is equal to A2. Therefore, A2 is equal to 2 meters per second square. It is 2 meters per second square. So you can write the answer. Applied force. You can write the answer as applied force is equal to 48 newtons. And acceleration of second object. And acceleration of second object is 2 meters per second square. It is 2 meters per second square. It is 2 meters per second square. Now, the next one. That is question 7C. A bullet having a mass of 10 kg and moving with a speed of 1.5 meters per moving with a velocity of 1.5 meters per second penetrates a thick wooden plank of mass 90 grams. The plank was initially at rest. The bullet gets embedded in the plank and both move together. Determine their velocity. Children, what is this sum? We have a gun. A bullet is getting fired from a gun and it is moving towards the plank. So, mass of the bullet is given as 10 grams. So, 10 grams we are going to convert into kgs. So, divide by 1000. Remove this 10. So, you are left with 1 by 10, 100. So, 1 by 100 is 1 by 10 square. So, this can be written as 1 into 10 to the power minus 2 kgs. Correct? Now, initial speed of the bullet. Before the bullet came out of the gun. The bullet was inside the gun. And as soon as it came out of the gun, it started moving with a speed of 1.5 meters per second. 1.5 meters per second. Correct? So this is in kgs and this is in meters per second. So this is SI unit. Correct. Now what is the mass of the wooden plank? Mass of the wooden plank is 90 grams. And you know how to convert that. 90 you have to divide by 1000 kgs. So cut 10. So you are left with 9 by 100. That is 9 into 10 to the power minus 2 kgs. So we have converted 90 grams in the exponential form. And we have also converted 10 grams in the exponential form. Now, as you can see in the beginning, the plank is not moving. And they have mentioned here, the plank was initially at rest. So the initial velocity of the plank is going to be 0. The initial velocity of the plank is going to be 0. This much is clear? Okay. Now, after firing, what happens? This bullet which is traveling with a speed will go and strike on the plank. It will go and strike on the plank. And the bullet and the plank will move together. The bullet and the plank will move together. So, in that case, we are going to take the mass as M1 plus M2. The moment the bullet goes and hits the plank, it penetrates into the plank and they move with a common velocity V. And they start moving with a common velocity V. So, what is asked in the question? They want to know that common velocity. What they want us to calculate is the common velocity. Now, according to law of conservation of momentum, this is the total momentum before collision and this is the total momentum after the collision. Okay, so let us substitute now. Our M1 is 1 into 10 to the power minus 2 and our U1 is 1.5 plus M2 is 9 into 10 to the power minus 2 and U2 is 0. And on the other side, M1 is again 1 into 10 to the power minus 2 and M2 is 9 10 to the power minus 2 and V. Correct? Now as you can see children, 0 is here. So this entire term will become equal to 0. So 1 into 10 to the power minus 2 into 1.5 is equal to, this is 9 plus 1 which is 10. 10 into 10 to the power minus 2 into V. So we can cancel 10 to the power minus 2. We can cancel 10 to the power minus 2. So we are only left with this much. Therefore V is equal to 1.5 by 10. So that is equal to 0.15 meters per second. So what is the question? Determine their velocity. So their common velocity V is equal to 0.15 meters per second. 0.15 meters per second. So children, already you know the conversion of gram into kilogram, that we have to do. And then we have to use law of conservation of momentum. In the second half, the masses are getting joined and they move with the common velocity, and that is what they have asked us to find.